Hello students, welcome to the series on advertising. Today we are going to study television advertising. Now let's study the objective of this chapter. The basic objective is to study the importance of television advertising and the impact of television advertising on audience. Now let's first study the evolution of television. Television made its entry in 1950 in America. It is the scientific synchronization of sound, light, motion, color and immediacy. In India, transmitting stations are called Doordarshan Kendras. Color transmission started in 1982 on the eve of Asiad 82 in India. The telecasting system is based on the coverage, namely VHF and UHF. VHF means very high frequency band spectrum and UHF means ultra high frequency band spectrum. Now the television is like a revolution for masses because this is one industry which has connected people, and still it is an accepted media of entertainment, and it is accepted media that people cannot do without television. It works on the spectrum space, that is the frequency has to be there for telecasting programs. So the very high frequency band spectrum and the ultra high frequency spectrum helps the programs to be channelized in a direction. CATV, CATV which means the community antenna television system, which is popularly known as cable television. With the advent of cable television, a viewer can select from a choice of several channels, all offering lot of good programs with lot of advertisements. Types of television advertising. There are two types of advertising in television. One is the sponsored programs and one is announcement. Now, television basically is a media industry where this space is also being sold to the advertising agencies. So, according to the power of the advertising agency, that is how much business they have, they try to buy these spaces. So, if they are working for a very large number of sponsors and advertisers, they can go for sponsored programs. But if the agency has less business and is not able to connect with a very big network of advertisers, they will go for announcements. Now, let us see the program or the sponsored program advertisers. It is a type of telecast where a story play, a film, is sponsored by the advertiser who pays for the time to advertise his products. The merits are it builds an image of its products and the program can be designed to fit the sponsor and his product. See, if they are into giving you products like related to food, oil or something, so they will design a program of recipes and they will tell you how you can use a particular product so that the customers can understand the nutritional value, the customers can understand how the product can be in taste and in convenience. The advertisements of the product is specific, that is you will not find advertisements of sports in food channels or vice versa. So people related to fashion industry would see fashion ads and they will have those kinds of programs designed, especially the fashion walks or the telecast of the basic events which are happening in the industry. So, you have industry specific programs being designed according to the interest and the taste of the audiences. So, here the sponsor is buying the total space and on the basis of hours he is paying to the media, and in this particular hour he will design a story, will give you the program and also the advertisement. So, he is free to choose what he has to do with that space. Announcement. Announcement is a telecast which is presented to audience between the sponsored program and station break. Advertisers pay only for the duration of advertisement. Majority of the advertisers go in for this type. Now, announcement is that the media, they have to fill with their programs. If nobody is buying, they produce their own programs and float on the channel. But in between, they can give the ads for the sponsors. Now, this is a cheaper way of doing business because you buy only spaces in minutes or in seconds so as to reach the audiences. Most of the advertisers resort on announcements rather than on programs. Advantages of announcements. It is very economical, it is more flexible, and it is effective for advertisements that are brief. These television commercials can be 10, 15, 20 and 30 seconds duration. So, when you go for advertising through announcements, it is very economical and you can connect with many channels, you can connect at many times. So, the ad will have a higher recall value as compared to the amount of money you invest on the sponsored programs. Advantages, it has an ability to create the deep impact. Television a perfect synchronization of sound, light, motion and color. It successfully catches the viewer's attention. It is an ideal medium to exhibit products including its demonstration. TV commercials very nearly replaces personal selling. Now, television is one kind of media which is connected to audience lifestyle. People have grown up with television, people get up in the morning and they put on the TV, or people when are sleeping they are connected to the television systems, because here you don't have to do that extra effort of clicking and changing and waiting for websites to be opened if the bandwidth is internet is going slow. So, television telecast is more structured, it's more professional and it has high band spectrum for telecast to be in quality. So, that quality gives the comfort of being connected with the system. So, when you're connected with channels, they're selling and they're advertising products, but there are shopping channels which are giving you products and the phone number is there. So, TV basically is replacing personal selling. In personal sellings, you are going door to door to ask customers to buy your products, but through television channels you can do the same functions to the masses if people are interested in those particular products, or if the people are into industry, they will watch these channels so as to see what is the cost and what is the promotion. Selective and flexible. TV is highly flexible and a selective medium. It can be used locally, regionally and nationally. The advertisers are free to choose time slots and nature of message to viewers through sponsored programs and announcement. Now, because the channels are in thousands, like they are in local languages also, there are religious channels also. So, the diversity and the flexibility of connections is immense, whereas with internet the language barrier is there. The most of the illiterate population who cannot read cannot connect to internet, because reading is a difficult thing which people need to learn. But since the population in India is rural based and people have no access to most of the high internet speeds, and people have no access to costly gadgets. So, here mass media television plays an important role in connecting to the audiences who basically are in local areas where they understand local language and they celebrate the local festivals. So, if you want to have a sales related to Onam, obviously the internet, the whole internet cannot be flooded with Onam goods, but the local channel and a local area and a local market and a local state can be connected through televisions. So, the diversity is immense where it cannot be replaced. Television still a very big industry where people are attached to their systems. Mass communication media. Television viewing is highly popular even in rural India. It is a mass medium where an entire family is exposed to it, perhaps for several hours a day. So, television advertising is considered a platform for gaining popularity for a product. Now, television is one thing, whether you are working in kitchen, you are cleaning your house, or whether you are spending a family time, you are putting on the system for music, entertainment or program. So, family is connecting all the members. If there is a group of friends who want to enjoy a cup of tea, obviously individually you cannot connect to your own gadgets. So, that system of TV will connect a group of people, maybe it is in clubs or in restaurants or in families. It is a popular mode to connect a group of people with same level of frequency and same level of understanding and feelings. It helps distributors and dealers. TV campaign of a product or a service is appreciated by dealers and local merchants. TV has more prestige and glamour than any other media. Now, if ads have appeared on TV, it obviously is more status for all the sponsors, and here it makes easy for the dealers also to explain the product. Like if the audiences already have seen the flash of ad on TV, they need less education so as to demonstrate the product usage. It is immensely popular. Of all media, TV is closest to replicate the actual life condition. It presents events as they are and as they happen. This offers limitless opportunity for advertising. TV is popular because you have recorded programs, you have live programs. It basically gives you, as things are made, in that perfect sense of color, presentation, and perfect a sense of what has to be given to the audiences. So, audiences are attracted to television because it has limitless opportunities of giving you entertainment and also giving you the effort of programs which are generally close to your heart. Television is a powerful means of media communication. Quality of presentation has a good impact on communication efficiency. Dynamic character is given by people involved in this process with expressed feelings and voices. High coverage makes transmission of message to a larger number of potential buyers. Now, the artists who are involved in making ads or in programs, they are very trained people. They express their feelings with their quality of voice and with the power of their personality. So, people who have immensely worked in the industry and have got the prestige and have understood the media, they are able to influence a larger public, and this influencing power helps them to, you know, carry the sponsors ads to that level and to that reach. Limitations of advertising in television. It suffers a short life. The commercial message on TV has a very short life. It is very expensive. High cost of advertising on television is another serious limitation. Too many commercials. TV advertising suffers from overcrowding of too many commercials in a very short span of time. Though this media is very popular, but it is cluttered. Most of the competitors, most of the sponsors, most of the advertisers are ready to pay and float their ads. But when there are too many ads, it is difficult for audiences to connect and to remember. So, this media has become cluttered and it has also become costly. Limitations continued. There are certain restrictions in case of products such as cigars, alcohol, beverages, etc. Message may not always reach the target audience. Quality of program can be advantage or disadvantage for the commercial. There are certain products which cannot be publicly advertised, like cigars, cigarettes, and alcohol is banned on TV. So, they have no other option to reach to the audiences through internet or through other social platforms. Now, TV has a restriction that, you know, the program quality which is made, the story, the emotions which have been created can go against the product sponsors or can go with the sponsors. So, what storyline is being chosen, what theory, what morality, or what is the quality of the commercial, how the program is made impacts the advertiser's message also. Now, let us study the average minute rating for measuring the TV's ad success. Average minute rating represents the average number of viewers per minute at a certain time for a certain TV channel. When you flourish an ad in a channel is like what will be the viewership in a particular channel for a particular time, that is maybe it is a minute or hour or maybe in a week, what is the viewer time. So, average minute rating is per minute rating, that is how many times the viewers have seen the ads in 1 minute. Television rating, that is TVR. Television rating is an indicator similar to the AMR, and it represents the average number of viewers per minute of all TV channels at a certain time. Now, this basically measures the connected audience to the television system. In 1 minute, how many people are viewing TV, that is TVR. Reach represents the number of viewers who watched at least 1 minute a certain TV channel at a certain time. This indicator is also calculated as a percentage of the whole population. That is, how many people have watched a particular channel. This is in relation to the total population available. So, you will get the percentage. Now, let us study exclusive reach. ER represents the number of those who at a certain time have watched at least 1 minute only a certain TV channel. Now, how do we rate the popularity of channel that at least for 1 minute a person must have watched a particular channel? So, that represents the number of people who have watched that particular channel at least for 1 minute. So, this will give you the exclusive reach of specific channels in terms of languages and in terms of telecast. ATS represents the average time spent by a viewer on a certain TV channel, that is all of them. That is, it is the number of hours a person is putting on particular channel, that is your average time spent. Only the persons who have watched at least 1 minute at a certain time are taken into account. Now, if you are flipping the remote and changing the channels every second, then that is the channel has been not able to attract the attention. But you are at least waiting and giving 1 minute to a particular channel, then it will be included in your average time spent for that connection. Virtual advertisements. They may be inserted into regular programming through computer graphics. It is typically inserted into otherwise the blank backdrops or used to replace local billboards that are not relevant to remote broadcast audiences. Now, sometimes we have the backdrops where we are trying to advertise certain things, and here you cannot put a banner ad like what is available on internet, or you cannot insert a billboard in TV transmission. So, you need to synchronize the advertisement in such a way that it is as a backdrop and the features and the characters they are playing in front of it. Virtual billboards. More controversially, virtual billboards may be inserted into the background when none existed in real life. This technique is specially used in television sporting events. Virtual product placement is also possible. Now, when you see the cricket matches or the sports events or the activities, generally the billboards are inserted at the boundaries or at the fencing. So, as the characters are running, as you can see the advertised product, which is as a billboard, but it is at the backdrop. So, most of the virtual billboards are used in television advertising, which are immensely connecting to the audiences because you are connected to that particular event. Infomercial in television advertising. An infomercial is a long format television commercial, especially 5 minutes or longer. Target audience can see the presentation and immediately buy the product through advertised toll-free telephone number or a website. Now, infomercial is basically telecasted through televisions where numbers are given and websites and links are given, so that people can connect to that link, fill up their forms, or you know, can get recruited, or they can sell their products, they can buy online. So, television is a mass media where all information is broadcasted, so that you reach to a number of audiences. Now, internet is very selected, that is, if you click it, you get connected. So, this is the difference between public messages, and internet is little bit more customized. Functions of infomercials. Infomercials describe, display, and often demonstrate products and the features. They commonly have testimonials from customers and the industry professionals. So, this infomercial basically helps the audiences to connect, and it can also be used to get donations if there is some calamity. So that information, when it is on TV through a telephone number and a link, people get connected and try to make a group where they can change the purpose or design system to buy or sell the products. So this is an important media to commercially connect with the audiences, and also the information which is given on television is not as fake as it is on internet, because here the testimonials are given, the sponsors are identified, and it is a verified media. That is, the media is owned and sponsored. So before coming to the televisions, you have to give your ID proofs and you have to give your validity as a recognized entity. Now let's study the summary of this lecture. In this lecture, we have studied television advertising. The evolution of television as a media of telecast has been a revolution and has been a blessing for mankind. The connections are commercial, the connections are intellectual, and the connections are economical, political, and socially beneficial to all segments of the society. It is a mass media to publicize good information, news, entertainment, and with this, advertising reaches to the audiences. So, television is an important media to advertise products and services. Thank you, students.